So I completed my first data analyst course 6 years ago, and you won't believe what happened. Within a week, I landed my first job and went on to become the senior vice president analytics in my organization. Scratch that. I didn't land my first job in a week, nor am I the senior vice president analytics, but I learned a few job hunting tips and strategies that can help you land a job faster. What's up guys, Wally here, welcome back to the channel. As many of you are starting to wrap up your courses and certificates, naturally the next line of action is to start job hunting. But hunting down a job requires proper techniques in order to succeed. And so in this video, I'm going to share 5 tips that can help you navigate your job search successfully. Without further ado, let's jump in. Tip 1 is to strive to get experience. This is probably the first challenge that confronts every beginner in the job market. It is the chicken and the egg problem of getting experience. Ideally, companies expect that at the point of completing your degree, you must have done some sort of internship, which gives you a base to start from. If you don't have an internship to refer to, then you must offer yourself as a volunteer. Volunteering requires you to freely give your time and labor for community service that you can easily reference in your resume and at interviews. And the easiest places you can get to volunteer are in churches, schools, hospitals, and local supermarkets. In fact, churches and schools are the most common and easiest places to start. For example, I started my data analysis work experience by volunteering for a primary school next to where my parents lived. There, I was able to put together a dashboard of student demography, daily attendance, student performance reports, payment status, school fees, price comparison, and so on. I recall relishing that experience because usually many of these type of organizations do not have their data in order. So I found myself designing and implementing an end-to-end solution from data collection to data cleaning, to data analysis and visualization. And that gave me raw, undiluted experience that I was able to reference in my resume and also talk about at interviews. So consider any of these organizations as a perfect place to start and soak in as much knowledge as possible. Tip number 2 is to build a good resume. A good resume is what stands between getting a positive response and a negative response. If your resume is not good enough, you will likely not get any callbacks. But the good news is your resume can and should always be improved on. One of the big mistakes I made while building my resume far back 6 years ago was choosing the wrong resume strategy. There are 2 resume strategies to choose from when setting out to design a resume: a chronological resume or a functional resume. A chronological resume is when you list your work experience in order of when it occurs, with the most recent work experience at the top. The problem with this resume strategy is that it is good for those who want to show a depth of experience or career progression, and not necessarily for beginners or career changers who have no functional work experience. A functional resume, however, focuses on your skills and ability rather than your work experience. And so because at this point, you really don't have any work experience to show off, but you've got a lot of skills that you can put on your resume. So for me, this is the resume strategy that I think is best for beginners who have 0 work experience. Now, if you want more information on building a functional resume, you can check out this link here or in the description below. Now, once your resume strategy is set, the next item to improve on your resume is your language and wordings. You must strive to make your wordings brief and clear. Use bullet points to describe your skills and achievements. For your volunteer experience, state briefly what your individual achievement was. Use action verbs such as championed, drove, optimized, and so on. Make sure you are blowing your trumpet at its loudest. Now, tip number 3. Put more applications out there. When you are starting out as an entry-level data analyst, it really is a numbers game. The more applications you put out, the higher your chances of securing a job. I know people say, oh, always look at the position to see if it's a good fit before applying. The truth is, you don't have anything to lose if you decide to apply for a job that isn't a good fit. Of course, apply smartly. Make sure you tailor your resume to fit. But if you meet like 40 or 50% criteria, apply. Don't hold back, push it in. Now, where do you get the jobs to put in applications for? Well, I must admit, there aren't that many data analyst jobs to go around, and it will make sense to cast your net wider. So consider looking into related disciplines. For example, the skills you learned as a data analyst can as well be adopted for a business analyst role. This will give you a wider pool of jobs to apply for and a wider range of skills to explore. Like I always say, I didn't start off as a data analyst. I had to first volunteer for a school, then I almost went into banking as a teller before I got a customer service role. Of course, at that time, I wasn't happy that I didn't land a data analyst job right off the bat. But what I didn't know is that I can always work my way back, which I did. So be open-minded, don't be afraid to venture out. If data analysis is truly what you want, the universe will bring you the opportunity to find your way back. Tip number four is to network smartly. You stand a better chance of getting a job when someone recommends you for the job. But how do you get someone to recommend you for a job? Well, there are many ways, and LinkedIn is one of them. Attending events is another. Joining community and groups is a third. Speaking to people you already know is a fourth. Whatever options or combinations you choose to adopt, make sure that every time you make a professional connection with someone, you let them know what you are capable of with respect to your skills. You must find ways to communicate and demonstrate your skills to them, even without them asking. This is not showing off. It is putting yourself out there for others to see. For example, don't just join a community and keep quiet. You must contribute something to that community, however small, to help someone. Don't write a cold email without value proposition. Don't attend an event and hide at the back of the room. And finally, don't fail to let people you already know that you are looking for a job. It takes only one person to know an employer who is recruiting for you to have a potential foot in the door. Now, tip number five, trust the process. Job hunts are difficult, stressful, and draining. So it is important that you trust the process and not get yourself overwhelmed. You'll have plenty rejections, but the good thing is you only need one yes on one acceptance to erase all the rejections. And that is what your focus should be on. Also, don't forget to have fun while job hunting. Find a buddy where you both can talk about latest happenings in the industry. If possible, attempt to rekindle or establish relationships with people within the industry. If one of your old classmates works in an organization or a role you'll love to know about, offer to take them out on a drink and enjoy the moment. Because at the end of the day, job hunting is a phase. And just like every phase in life, it will come and it will go. And guess who will be standing at the other side? You. Anyway, that is from me today. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, do smash the like button and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.